I request that we all give a standing ovation to this excellent speech, please.
Let me first start by congratulating the graduating students of the day. Give them a big hand. Good morning, all the graduating students and other students and dignitaries who are part of the audience. And good morning to the distinguished guests on the dais. You would have seen a difference, right? This is not the way most of the time most people do, because we always start with the chief guests, we talk about the people on the dais, and then come back to audience. Tiago asked me a question. Sir, what is the tradition equivalent to convocation in our scriptures? I said, go and read a full chapter of Type 3 Upanishad. And it's two things I want you to remember. One, it talks of Namasadase, Namasadasaskataye. Very good. What is interesting is, greet the people in the audience, that is the students, and then greet the people on the dais, that is the professor. Right? The order is very clear. Second, more important stuff. In fact, many things which many of you would know actually comes from the chapter. Satyam Vada, Dharmam Chara, all of them are part of the chapter. But most important for you to remember, I think there is the strength of the Indian tradition. We are absolutely clear that we are human beings, and Mr. Narendra keeps talking about the infallibility of human being and the glory of the God. So what the teacher says is, whatever great things which you found in us, take it, follow. Whatever not so great things which you found in us, drop it in the dustbin. That is the clarity of vision of our CS. And that is something which I want you to carry. Okay. So what I will do is that I was given 9 minutes, I will try to finish in 8 minutes. Okay. I'm happy to be with you all today. And being a celebration movement, the last thing you want is a boring lecture from a professor, right? So I am aware of that, so I will ensure that I don't do that. But I thought this is the time for you to get some inspiration. And you must have heard of amazing, in fact there is a site devoted to convocation addresses. Go and take a look at it. The talk in that is the one given by Steve Jobs. It is called Stay Hungry, Stay Foolish. Do read that. So I'm kind of taking a message from there. The message for you is one simple thing. Make a difference. Make a difference. Let me start. You are graduating today with a great education, thanks to Sona. And of course, including the schools and colleges you might have gone before coming to Sona. But remember, less than 10% of your age group in India gets this amazing opportunity of college education. The 90% are not lucky. What can you do about it? It's a mammoth job. And you might say that, look, sir, you know, we have to talk of millions and millions of people, we just can't do, and then forget it. Don't forget. Can you help those who did not get college education in a meaningful way? There could be security guards, there could be taxi drivers, there could be janitorial staff. Can you identify a handful of such people, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, around you, and can you kind of help them to send their children to school and college? That would be a way by which you can make a difference. You can help them monetarily. You can help them to provide tuition to their children. Whatever way, do not get daunted by the millions of people that need to be helped. Start today, not tomorrow. Start today with at least one family. That will make a difference to your neighborhood. That will make a difference to your neighborhood. Second, you all will get a job. You already have a job, most of you. It is easy to complain. My manager gives me boring job. My company does not pay the highest salary. I do not get the first opportunity to go abroad. You can go on and on and on. Instead, can you turn the argument around? I will ensure that I will execute the job with the highest commitment. Can you say, I will go beyond the call of my duty and excel in my job? Instead of worrying about how well your salary compares with your counterparts, can you ensure that your value addition to the company is many, many times over the salary that you get? If you get a 5 lakh salary, can you create a value of 50 lakhs? I think that is the challenge which I want you to do. And if you do enough of it, and enough of you do it, your company will be the best in class. And that is the difference you can make to your company. Last but not the least, every day you read some depressing news in the newspapers today. Politicians, bureaucrats, engineers, doctors, and even some professors are corrupt. It is easy to criticize that the whole country is corrupt. Instead, can you turn the argument around? You and your friends want to watch a movie. What do? You all collect together, get into your car, SUV, drive, go to the cinema hall. You are in a hurry, you want to see that particular movie in that particular movie hall on that day for that show. It's perfectly fine. What you find sometimes is you do not have enough tickets. What do? You flaunt your money. You flaunt your position. You do not mind bribing the clerk, few hundreds of rupees. So what, sir? Few hundreds of rupees. The guy makes it, he gives me a ticket, maybe 1,000 rupees. And you happily watch the movie and come back. Oftentimes, the movie could be Chakde India. Right? But what is the message you are giving? Are you not inconsistent? Well, you find fault with a politician who loots the country of thousands of crores of rupees, you do not mind bribing a few hundreds of rupees. Remember, big corruption starts with small corruption. Big corruption starts with small corruption. Can you introspect? Can you practice what you want to see in others today, not tomorrow? If you do that, you will make a difference to this country. I do not want to go on and on. I just want to make an appeal. As you celebrate your graduation, you should celebrate, of course, you have worked so hard. You should celebrate. Let me give you a big hand again. You should celebrate. But do think of making a difference. Any success you will make you proud, make your parents sitting behind proud, make the institution proud, and the country proud. Let me kind of conclude with a homework, because professors always have to give a homework. And Mr. Narendra talked about going to the moon. The homework for you is your children's generation. That means your son, your daughter-in-law, or son-in-law. You have to ensure that they celebrate their honeymoon in the moon. Right? It's going to be possible. Okay, and you have to ensure celebrate. I can tell you, I have some credibility to make the statement. I went to the same school, I was in the same building. The first man who put the foot on the moon happens to be a Purdue alum. I went to Purdue University. The second man who put the foot on the moon is a Purdue alum. More important, the last man so far who has ever put his foot on the moon happens to be a Purdue alum. So I have the credibility. So I want you to kind of ensure that your children celebrate honeymoon on the moon, and Mr. Narendra will ensure Indian Overseas back with funding. Thank you.